The Office of Public Accountability has issued its audit of Revenue Tax's gross receipt tax exemptions. Auditor in charge Rachel Field explains.
That was the initial audit that we were going to do, but what we had found was that there was a backlog in processing of gross receipt tax forms.
That backlog dates back 2 years and revealed DRT has not processed GRT forms and assessed taxes and exemptions since then. Audit Supervisor Franklin Cooper Nurse says it happened for a number of reasons, some very technical in nature.
We had a system failure. We had an interface breakdown between the Treasury of Guam and the Department of Revenue Taxation. That coupled with the scanner not being utilized, that going down, as well as a termination of a contract with the vendor provider, really put DRT in a weak position and in a bad position.
As a result, for 2 years, the Business Privilege Tax Branch did not scan or input GRT tax and exemptions data from tax forms into its systems, specifically totaling close to 80,000 GRT forms. Basically, Public Auditor Doris Flores Brooks says it was a perfect storm of events that hit DRT.
So if a taxpayer voluntarily pays, that is recorded. If a taxpayer doesn't file, there's no way of knowing who was not filed. So that's really where the risk is. Who are the non-filers or the under-reporters? No one knows for sure how many people are out there like that.
Fortunately, there were some compensating controls in regarding GRT payments involving the Department of Administration, Treasurer of Guam, and its point-of-sale system and the AS-400. Cooper Nurse, however, says a lot of time is spent manually inputting data because of the system not working.
There was a lot of redundant work. There's a lot of time being spent on manually inputting rather than analyzing, using this information to report to your managers, to your directors, and using that information to make sound decisions in regards to taxes.
The OPA has since recommended DRT work with the governor, legislature, and DOA in three areas, including establishing a tax administration task force and a financial management task force. Auditor Vincent Duenas explains.
Going in line with the e-filing to establish and actually have a target date, we asked management, can you please set a target date so that we can shoot for that, so that you can shoot for that, so that you can fully transition to the electronic filing for the gross receipts tax and all other related taxes.
Revenue Tax Director John Camacho, meanwhile, has indicated that transitioning to e-filing will improve efficiency and offer several benefits.
Basically, I guess we basically concur with her comments and recommendations on the audit of the gross receipt tax exemptions.
Camacho adds DRT has provided the figures for 2006 to 2010. For 2011 and 2012 GRT forms, they'll be processed this month, along with those from 2013 currently being processed. Ultimately, he says DRT is trying to improve the system.
We're working at a pace that we will get back on track.
The public auditor, meanwhile, says unlike past administration directors, DRT management and staff have been accepting of the OPA and hopes this audit will be a wake-up call that DRT needs to be strengthened in order to improve revenue collections.
And hopefully this audit will wake everybody up that we need to invest today so that we can have the right information tomorrow.
Following this audit, the OPA is also working on more reports dealing with revenue tax, specifically with the real property taxes and the qualifying certificate program. Reporting for Guam's News Network, I'm Ken Quintanilla.
Also tonight, Senator Michael Sinicolas, who has oversight over revenue tax, reacted to the audit, saying his committee's recent oversight hearings with that agency have shed light on issues with collections and waivers of penalties, and the OPA's audit further highlights the magnitude of the situation. The chairman for regulatory concerns, as you can see on your screen, revenue tax is responsible for making sure that everyone is paying their fair share, and when that isn't being done, he writes, it calls into question the fairness of the entire tax collection process. My office, he continues, will continue to hold revenue tax accountable until the data shows real improvement. Senator Sinicolas adds that he will follow up on these issues during an oversight hearing on the 28th.